We are live. All right. Welcome everybody to our team call. I'm so excited that you are on tonight. We're going to have an awesome training on how to create a planning strategy. A fancy term for that would be marketing strategy, but I don't feel like I'm professional enough to have a marketing strategy. So we're just going to call it a post creation strategy. But I want to hit on a couple of things, a couple key announcements that you guys need to make sure you're aware of. Number one, the challenge packs are all $20 off. Every challenge pack across the board that's $150 or more is $20 off. And that's like crazy good savings. Now, the question that I'm getting a lot from my coaches is, well, what about next month when Morning Meltdown 100 launches? And so the question there is, do they have to double pay? Well, what they're going to be doing is they're going to be offering a promotional code. So like, you know, how you have websites that you enter a promo code and you get a certain amount off, that's what they'll do. So they'll get $20 off the packages for Morning Meltdown, and they're already going to be on sale. So they're going to get a double savings, or it's like a certain percentage off the digital access. So they'll get a discount regardless. So just rest assured that you're setting them up for the most benefit financially, so they don't have to wait. Okay, so that was not the second thing is that the Morning Meltdown 100 sample workout goes live into the BOD library on June 24th. So mark your calendars for that, because that's going to be like our test day where we get to like try it out together, which is going to be so awesome. I'm interested to see which workout they choose to try out. My guess is it's going to be Cardio Meltdown or Lit Cardio. And let me just tell you, you are in for a treat and a half. It's going to be so awesome. So those are really the two main things. There's a couple summit things going on for like photo shoots with the trainers and things like that. So if you're going to summit and you want information on that, just let me know and we'll connect. Go check the FAQ. It's all listed in your coach announcements. So all right, so our first order of business, we've gotten our announcements over. I'm going to start screen sharing, and then we're going to start talking about how to create a post strategy and hopefully can provide a lot of value to you guys tonight. Can everybody see my screen? Yes? Okay. So it should be real pretty pink and purple, correct? Yes? Okay. All right, so one of the things that I'm hearing a lot behind the scenes from my coaches is that they're struggling to know what to post, when to post, how to create a plan for the posting. They know they need to share every single day, but how do you come up with an organized system to where you feel less frazzled and more empowered? So that's my mission tonight, for you to have a clear vision of what you're trying to share on your social media. And this is like really strategy focused. So we're going to be doing some activities in here that's going to help you create some content for your social media. But the thing I want to touch on first is, and I was thinking, this is going to kind of sound a little weird. I was sitting in church on Sunday morning and I was thinking about, they're sharing the story in the Bible about how your house is either built on rock or it's built on sand, and the person's house who's built on the sand falls. And for some reason, I thought about our team and I thought about how that relates to our coaching business. And the coaches that build their coaching business on the proper foundation is going to withstand the storms in their business. And if you build your business around your transformation, your journey, being proof of the product, connecting with your story, that's your foundation to be built on the rock of your business. If you build it on invites without having a transformation to back it up, you're building it on the sand. If you build it on trying to harass everybody that you know without actually like living it out every single day, you are building your business on the sand. And so we're going to be talking tonight about specific strategies of posting, but I want to remind you that if your foundation of your business is not rock solid, and I've really been reflecting a lot on my business and how do I help my coaches and my team really see the success that I have, you know, felt so good about achieving, because helping you guys makes me feel so happy and like filled up and joyful. How do I help you feel that? And I look back on the last 3.5-4 years, I built my whole foundation solely around my transformation paired with my story. early on in my business, I figured out how to tell my story. And that is something you hear across the board. That's something we talk about a lot. And we're gonna talk about that a little bit, but we're really gonna talk about strategy and how to lay it out in a way that makes sense in your month. But I want you to know that that really does matter. And so over the net, we have Morning Meltdown 100 launch coming up next month. This is your time to commit to some kind of a program and show up every day and get results 1 month from today. So that when Morning Meltdown 100 comes out and is live, you can say, look, do you want kick butt results like I got for the last 30 days? It doesn't matter if they're doing the same thing as you did in the last 30 days or not. They see that it works because they trust you for what your journey is and your story because you showed up every day. And I'm going to brag on Stephanie just a little bit. So Stephanie shared with me today, she has built her foundation of her business on her transformation. Not that anybody else hasn't, like everybody on this team has. But this is an example of how that pays off. You build your foundation of your business around your transformation and sharing your story consistently. And she had somebody in her break room today come up to her and be like, girlfriend, you have lost a crap ton of weight. What in the heck are you doing? Sign me up. I'm ready today. Like, that's the foundation for success. When you built your business around showing people and creating belief in what we offer, that's what this is about. So just keep that in mind as we're going through tonight. Like, your foundation needs to be on the rock. So take a second, look at your business. What is your foundation? I don't know why that came to me in the middle of a sermon on Sunday, but hey, hopefully it was helpful. All right, so we're going to go through, or I'm going to give you 6 easy steps to building this posting plan. So the first step, and I'm actually going to show you a calendar, so I'm going to show you how to do this. It's going to be super easy. Personally, I recommend if you are a like planner, I am not, I don't like planners. I have flopped on every planner I've ever tried. Brooke is the opposite. She's a planner rock star. So that's not my strength, but even though it's not my strength, I can still effectively create a posting plan that's going to benefit me and my business. So the first step is know what you're inviting to. So you are like, what is your month? What are you doing right now in your business? If you were to go share this opportunity with someone, what are you inviting them to? Like, what do you have going on in your business? Without that monthly group game plan, you're going to struggle to create a clear vision on your social media because you don't have a game plan behind the scenes. So they're not going to know. You're not going to be able to share a game plan when you don't have one. So things to consider when planning. And I know that Brooke's team and my team, we both run things together. So our team offers all of this and Brooke's team offers all of this. So it's super simple that most of this is already set out for you. But if it is not, then you have the opportunity to create this for yourself. So things to consider when planning your groups for the month, your monthly challenge group. So this is your boot camp of the month, theme it, whatever, do a specific program. So your boot camp, the next thing would be a free group. So this is like a free 5-day challenge. And then the last thing would be a coach sneak peek. So how are you sharing this incredible business opportunity that's given you so much passion? So those are kind of the areas that you want to look at when mapping out your monthly plan. So I'm going to show you our team's monthly plan. And I know that some of this mimics Brooke's because she and I are running MomStrong together. So step 2 is to know your timelines of your group. So here you can see my team calendar. So this is a loose structure. Every second Monday of the month, we start a 21-day boot camp. Every third Thursday of the month, we do a sneak peek. And then every last week of the month, we do a free group. So here you have it laid out. We actually have 2 groups this month, which is rare for us. So this month, we started Fit Games Boot Camp. And we also have MomStrong. So you can see that Fit Game Prep Week starts the first week of the month. The second week of the month, our focus is now MomStrong Prep. So we're focusing now on MomStrong, the boot camp that we're running with Brooke's team. Then the week after, we're going to be focusing on coaching and our coaching webinar. And then the last week of the month, we're going to be focusing on a free group. All of these, as you guys have the benefit of having leaders that actively work their business. So we are providing basically all of these resources to you. So this is all pretty much laid out. So this is the easy part. Now, step 3 is going to be to get detailed on each day. And this is going to help you in your posting here in a second. And I'm going to tie it together and show you how. So create an inviting and posting vision for every day so that you know exactly what your purpose purposes when you show up to build your business. So on Monday, June 10th, what am I going to, instead of sitting down at my power hour and wanting to share this incredible opportunity that I have and be like, oh, what's going on? I don't even know. Like, what am I supposed to be inviting to? This is your posting strategy. So I know that today I'm going to be inviting to Mom Strong. I'm going to be sharing this incredible boot camp that I'm so passionate about because I love to help postpartum mamas. I love to help pregnant mamas. And so that I'm going to be inviting to Mom Strong. Then next Monday, you really cannot see it. It's so small. But invite to Sneak Peek plus free group. So the next week, starting next Monday, that's going to be my focus. I'm going to be inviting to free group and the Coach Sneak Peek. Now here's the thing, with Morning Meltdown coming next month, everyone that tells you no or not right now, they immediately go onto your list to talk to about Morning Meltdown next month because it's a brand new program. You're going to have all this information from the test group. And so that they're going to be on your not right now list, maybe next month, and share with them about Morning Meltdown. So at this point, you've got a strategy for what you're wanting to talk about on your social media or in your invites behind the scenes, and everything is laid out and pretty and it's organized and you understand it, okay? Can I get a thumbs up if that makes sense for everybody? Yes, okay. All right, so now your step four is you're gonna be doing a brain dump. So this is where we're actually gonna take some action time. So we're gonna do a brain dump and I'm just going to do a little bit of one of these categories, but I'm gonna give you some examples. This is how you come up with content to put on all those days of the month. Now I'm structuring this on a 5 day a week game plan. I tend to, on the weekends, I shift very much to family and life stuff. And then on Sunday nights, I try to do a call to action post. But so this is based off of 5 days. 5 days of the week, you want to be sharing intentionally what you've got going on in your business. So in your brain dump, you want to think of these four different categories, and there are more, but these are just the four that I thought of. So I'm going to scroll back and forth so you can see them. So number one is your body. Number two is your mind. Number three is the impact of those around you. And number four is joy. And so what do those mean? It means when you, so here are some question prompts, and we're going to go through this in just a second. So think of an old picture that everyone, who has a picture of their, what I'll call their, well, I hate the word fat. That's such a derogatory word, but their heavy picture. They have a picture that they saw of themselves and they thought, they gasped and they thought, oh my God, that is not me. Who has a picture like that? Yeah. Okay. So I want you to think of that picture as you are looking at planning out your month. Think of that picture of the old you before this community. And what are the emotions that you think of? Okay, so this, we're going to actually take action. We're going to spend about 5 minutes on this category. I'm going to go do one more before we move on. So think about that picture. What are the emotions that you think of? Write down things like, here's some examples. I felt trapped in my body. I was miserable. I felt defeated. What did your body feel like before? I felt heavy. I had back pain. I had brain fog. So I'm going to set the timer for about 6 minutes, and then I may put some of you on the spot. Let me be in it. All right, timer set. I'm going to turn the tunes up.
Gatorade Zero presents Working Out with the Waves.
Okay, wait. I'm working out. I hydrate with Gatorade Zero. It has all the electrolytes, zero sugar.
Get out here. And I hydrate with Gatorade Zero because it has all the electrolytes and zero sugar.
Hey, I said it first.
You wish you were first.
Hey, wait.
Gatorade Zero. All the electrolytes, zero sugar.
Screaming in my name. I'm a piece of the hell of a piece of the night.
I do want to say, if you are someone who is new, because we have a couple of new coaches within the team, so I'm going to talk about how to do this as a newer coach also. Almost done. All right. Okay, so now you would do this, and I will be happy to share this in the team pages, but this is just an opportunity for you to kind of, okay, what are you trying to say in your post? And these are question prompts that can really help you tune into your story and what you're trying to share. So as a newer coach, this could probably feel like, well, I don't really have much to share. I would just encourage you to get in tune with what you're working to change. So if you're someone that is low energy and you are ready to feel energized and motivated and encouraged and inspired, you're going to share that you're starting out and that this is your long-term goal, but here's what you did today to get one step closer to that. So that's kind of how you approach it as a new coach. So Brooke, I'm going to unmute you and I'm going to put you on the spot. Love you, Bob. Love you. Okay. So Brooke, tell us some of your, like, what did your brain dump? Like, what were some of the things that went on your brain dump?
So I don't have a crazy weight loss story like a lot of it. Like Rachel's weight loss story is amazing. My first one was 35 pounds. So I think back to the picture of then, because I expected as a new mom that I was going to have extra weight. So I don't really look at those pictures the same, but I have a picture of me holding a cupcake, and I look at that picture and I feel disappointed, tired, defeated, ugly, and chubby.
Yeah. So then this is how you're going to tie that together. Thank you for sharing, Brooke. Mm-hmm. Okay, so this is how you're going to tie that together. So once you've sat down, and this is really important, this is something that you need to be doing every month. I will often take some time on a Saturday and look at old pictures, go through the different years where I was at my heaviest, because sometimes that brings up emotions that I didn't remember, and that has really helped me when doing this activity. So once you've taken that activity, you're going to start to put it all together. You're going to take your week at a glance. You could do an entire month if you have the time. That's great. It creates a clear vision. I encourage you by starting 1 week. So you're going to take 1 week. So I gave you an example of this week, and you're going to put it all together. You're going to take a topic and assign it to each of those days. So here's an example. Hopefully you guys can see it. So today, my June 10th, I'm going to be inviting to MomStrong. My post topic is going to be talking about comparing my obese pregnancy to my fit pregnancy and how I emphasizing the recovery aspect of how much easier it was having a healthy pregnancy. So that's my focus for Monday. Then Tuesday, I'm going to talk about my postpartum mental health. How did fitness help me overcome postpartum depression? And then you'll note that on each of these days, I have a little note at the very bottom of the day, and it says 7 days left, 5 spots. So when I'm writing out my content on for that post and I'm talking about my postpartum mental health and my postpartum depression, at the end of that post, I'm going to tag, I am so excited to help 5 ladies overcome the same struggles that I have had. MomStrong Bootcamp starts off in 6 days. Please message me if you want to learn more about it. And so you are continuously talking about MomStrong every single day. You can do the same thing in your story. So you put this somewhere where you can see it, and you know on Monday morning after you finish your workout, when you're feeling good and alive, you're going to get on, you're going to talk about how you have overcome postpartum depression or whatever your story is. So for Brooks, she would fill in the gaps of, you know, those words. She could put on Monday, defeated. She could put on Tuesday, felt chubby, you know, like she could put topics on each of those days and then create a post with that prompt. So the idea is not to necessarily sit down and write everything verbatim for the whole week. I know coaches that do that. I struggle with that because it doesn't feel as authentic to me to go so structured. I am very much an on-the-cuff kind of person, but it's important to have a vision for your week. And I am very guilty of this. I'm sharing this with you because it's not a strength of mine, and I want to improve. And Kayla and Brooke and I were chatting behind the scenes about our vision for like MomStrong, and we were talking about posting strategy. We're like, well, we know we need to do better. How do we do that? So here's how you would tie that together. And I see the chat going off. I'll make sure to get to it at the end. So does that make sense how you would take those brain dumps and put a topic on each day? Yes or no? Can I get some thumbs up if that makes sense? Okay. All right. So now what you would do is you're going to tie that together by having 2 to 3 posts on hand. So on Saturday morning or on Sunday night, when you are sitting around watching TV or whatever you're doing, you pull out that notebook with your brain dump and you start thinking, you connect to that story and you create a couple posts to have on hand so that you can share that. So you can be that inspiration. And that on Wednesday, when you know you have a heck of a day and you're going to be exhausted and your kids are going to be cray, and then you have church on Wednesday night and you got to pick up the kids from daycare and whatever your schedule looks like, you know that you've already prepared your post for Wednesday. You did that on Sunday when you had some extra time. And so there is never a time where there should be a lapse on your social media. So now, how do you tie this in if you're a new coach? So if you have not announced that you're in it, because we have several new coaches on the call who are in the process of learning how to announce that they're a coach, you would start by mapping that out. So you would say, okay, Tuesday is my day to announce that I'm a coach. On Wednesday, I'm going to share my selfie and I'm going to show the change that I have felt, and I'm going to talk about that piece of my story, and then I'm going to mention MomStrong. And then on Thursday, and so you just kind of create that same flow for yourself, but you started out by talking about how you launched your business, and then you carry that momentum through the week, is kind of the vision for that as a newer coach. I encourage you to embrace whatever your story is. You do not need to be at your goal weight or be where you want to be or have this crazy drastic transformation to have something that could encourage or inspire somebody. You may not know that you will connect with somebody who could be completely opposite of you. Like their goals may be, they may want to gain 10 pounds of muscle and you're over here trying to lose 50 pounds of fat. And what you shared about how you overcame anxiety and depression could impact them. And so they are your people because they share your story. So that's why it's so important to create this clear vision for your business each and every week. Because here's what happens. When you don't have a set idea of what you're doing for the week, you're just randomly throwing crap at the wall. Like you are literally just randomly throwing, been there, done that more times than I care to admit, but you're randomly throwing stuff at the wall and hoping that something sticks. This gives you the ability to not only tap into your story, but that your message is clear what you are doing in your business. It's not just, hey, join me, I have this going on. It's like, hey, there's 6 days left. Hey, there's 5 days left. Hey, there's 4 days left. And that creates this consistency and urgency. And some one of those posts is going to hit somebody at the right time. And they're going to be like, this is my time. I had somebody message me today. You know that she messaged me last year and was like, I'm all in. I want to change. I'm doing this. Ghosted me. twice. And I will be transparent. I sucked at following up with her. Somehow she slipped through the cracks. And she messaged me today and she's like, I've been following you forever and a year. And I am ready to feel what you are feeling right now. She's like, I see your joy radiate every single day. And I want that for myself. And that consistency of these groups and here's what's going on and here's what I've got, that impacts people. So that's step five. Step six is to do your crap. So social media is your business. And this, if you want to build any kind of income, you're going to have to treat your social media like a business. And I hate having to get technical like that because I am such a heart person. I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm in my feelings. I love to help people. It feels so good. But at the end of the day, you also are here to empower women to become their best self and empower women to build a business too, and to empower women to believe in themselves and to overcome doubts and struggles. And that's your job. And if you don't do your crap of showing up on social media, you cannot change a life. So if becoming a coach is fulfilling you in any way, it is your duty to show up on social media every single day because you're going to help somebody. And it's not about a challenge pack and it's not about a BOD membership. It is about helping one person. I share a lot about my marriage as much as I can comfortably with my husband's profession. And that has really touched a lot of people. And I don't do it for that. I do it because I want people to know that they're normal, that marriage is hard. And transitioning from one to two kids was part of my French hell. And so we're still working through that. And that I got more feedback from that today, and I just shared it because I wanted to encourage somebody. And if I didn't do my crap of showing up on social media every single day, I would not have the opportunity to encourage somebody. So set a reminder on your phone for every day. You don't miss what I'm not talking about. You have to do a call to action every day. I'm not talking about you got to say six spots, seven spots, buy this, do this. Just be present on social media and share your heart every single day. So set a reminder on your phone for that. So if that's what it takes, if you're someone who needs like, oh yeah, I haven't shared, hey, guess what? I got 2 to 3 posts on backup and I don't even have to think about it today. My alarm just went off. I'm going to throw up a post and boom, I'm done. And I've showed up today in my business on my page. I encourage you to take a little bit of time when you have a pocket of time in your schedule, maybe a Saturday morning, you go away to Starbucks and you sit in the glorious quiet and you create posts for your week. Maybe that's what that looks like for you. But I'm just going to challenge you to suck it up and do it anyways. Your business is your page, and this really is important. And so this posting strategy is going to give you the tools to feel empowered in your business, to have a vision for what you're doing, and you literally replicate this every single month. You could even take the same themes and topics and switch it up and mix them up around and write up a new post about the same topics and stuff until you feel like you're bored of what you have. Because your story will never get old. And if you retell it in different ways, then you're going to make an impact. So that's all I've got. That's step six of six. So I'm going to stop my screen share and see what the chat was going on. Okay. Can you reshare step four? Yes. Hold on a second. I'm going to reshare my screen step four. And then I want you guys to think about any questions that you have and we'll go from there. All right, it says, here's step four if you want to screenshot it. I'll upload it in the team page. Brooke, I'll send this to you. So here's step four. All right, anybody have any questions that they would be so brave as to ask?
Mueller.
Brooke, did you have anything you wanted to add? No?
You killed it. I'm just tired. I feel out of it tonight.
Oh, no. You're okay. I get really passionate. I'm like sweating right now. But I really want you guys to feel like social media is such a blessing. Like, honestly, it is such a blessing to get to share and think of the lives that you're going to change. And so it's your duty to show up. It's your duty to create a plan. If this doesn't work for you, then do what works for you. But honestly, you've got to show up and share your story. And if you want to build a foundation that's on the rock, this is the cornerstone of that. And so I just really want to challenge you to like embrace that and say, I'm going to do this and I'm going to rock this. And don't let any limiting belief that you're not a good writer, that's bull crap, that you don't know how to tap into sharing your story, that's bull crap. Yes, you do. You have to take the time to figure that out and be willing to fail in the process. I can look back on my social media right now. Like, I can pull up posts right now from 4 years ago when I started this business that are dookie. And I don't understand why anybody joined me in that first year, but I was just figuring it out because I didn't know don't share the products. Like, that doesn't speak to anybody. When I started tapping into my before and how I felt as I was changing, my business transformed. And so that has been a huge part for me. So, all right, we are good to go for tonight. Next week, we're going to be talking about belief in yourself and in your business. Is that right? That's the topic, right, Brooke? Okay, so Brooke's got next week's team call. And if she doesn't pop a baby out between now and then, how many weeks are you now, Brooke?
37 today.
37. So if at any point the team call changes last minute, it's because Brooke's a little bit busy. But we've got a lot going on. Remember, Mom Strong is coming up on Monday. That is still a huge opportunity for our teams to invite to. And if you do not have something to invite to, I know that we have Fit Fams that you can add people to right now. So there's a place for everybody. So, all right, I'm done running my mouth. I kept it 30 minutes. I'm gonna pat myself on the back. All right, we'll see you guys next week. Thanks for being on. Bye.